In this video, we'll take a closer look at the metric system and conversions. The modern form of the metric system, which scientists use for measurements, is called the SI, which stands for the French phrase Système International. It sets the standard for 7 base metric quantities, which are fundamental units that cannot be broken down further. In addition to the base units, there are many more derived units. Derived units are obtained by performing calculations using the base units. Now let's look at some SI units. The base unit for length is the meter, represented by the letter M. Time's base unit is the second, which is represented with an S. Temperature's base unit is the Kelvin, represented by a capital K. The base unit of mass is the kilogram, which is represented as kg. Now we get to volume, which is a derived unit rather than a base unit. Volume's unit is the liter, represented by a capital L. Remember, there are other SI base and derived units in addition to these examples. Next, let's look at a chart of metric conversions. Mega stands for 1 million and it's represented by a capital M. Kilo means 1,000 and it is shown by a lowercase k. Hecto stands for 100 and it is represented by an H. Deca stands for 10 and it is represented by DA. The base units, which we just reviewed, are liters, meters, Kelvin, seconds, and grams. There's an asterisk by the unit for gram because the base unit for mass is actually the kilogram. But for some of the conversions we're doing today, it will make more sense to assign this as a gram. And you'll soon see why. Deci stands for 1/10 and is represented with a D. Centi stands for 1/100 and it is represented with a C. Milli stands for 1/1000 and it is represented with an M. Micro stands for 1 millionth and it is represented by the Greek letter mu. Nano stands for 1 billionth and it is represented by a lowercase n. Pico stands for 1 trillionth and it is represented by a lowercase p. Here is a little mnemonic to help you remember metric prefixes when you are doing conversions. King Henry died by drinking chocolate milk. King represents kilo. Henry is hecto, died is deca, by is the base units, drinking is for deci, chocolate is for centi, and milk is for milli. Got it? When we're converting back and forth in the metric system, you can use this to determine how many places the decimal has to move. For example, if we were going from deca to kilo, we would be moving left 2 places according to the chart, which means the decimal would move to the left 2 places also. If we were going from deca to milli, then we would move 1, 2, 3, 4 places to the right, and that's how many places the decimal would need to move as well. Also, as you can see here, you can move the decimal point or multiply when going to the right, and when you're converting to the left, you can move the decimal point or you can divide. Now, let's do some practice problems that involve metric conversions. First, let's convert 15 milliliters to liters. So let's bring up the King Henry died by drinking chocolate milk chart. We put an understood decimal point after the 15 milliliters and we look at the chart and find milli here. And notice liters is one of our base units. So, if we're going from milliliters to liters, we have to move 1, 2, 3 places to the left, and that tells us what we have to do with the decimal. So we move the decimal point 1, 2, 3 places to the left, and anytime you have one of these dips where there is no number, you fill that in with a 0, and we get 0.015 liters. And you've converted 15 milliliters to liters. You could have also found this number by dividing 1,000 into 15 to get 0.015 liters. Now let's convert 25 liters to milliliters. So here's our 25 with the decimal point, which is understood. In this case, we're going from liters down to milliliters. And so on our King Henry chart, we go 1, 2, 3 steps to the right, which means the decimal point moves 3 places to the right as well. So here we move it, 1, 2, 3, and that's where the new decimal point goes. And we fill in the dips with zeros. And we end up with 25,000 milliliters. You could have also found this number by multiplying 25 by 1,000 to get 25,000 milliliters. The last problem asks us to convert from 155 kilograms to centigrams. Here are kilograms on our King Henry chart, and we want to convert all the way to centi. So we're going to move 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 places to the right, and then we do the exact same thing with the decimal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, making dips along the way. And so here is the new decimal place, and we fill in all these dips with zeros. And what we find is that we have 15,500,000 centigrams. We can write that as 15,500,000, or in scientific notation, you would write that as 1.55 times 10 to the 7th centigrams, written as CG. Now, here are some problems for you to try. When you're ready, you can press pause and write these problems down, and then do the conversions, remembering your King Henry died by drinking chocolate milk chart. When you're finished, press play, and we'll go over the solutions. Take the time you need to solve them using the King Henry chart. Convert 20 centimeters to meters. Convert 0.032 hectoliters to milliliters. Convert 45 kilograms to decagrams. Convert 805 decimeters to kilometers. Ready to see if you got them right? For the centimeters to meters, the correct answer is 0.02 meters, which we got by sliding the decimal 3 places to the left. For hectoliters to milliliters, the correct answer is 3,200 milliliters, which we arrived at by moving the decimal 5 places to the right. In our third problem, the correct answer is 4,500 decagrams, where the decimal slid 2 places to the right. And our last answer is 0.0805 kilometers, which we got by sliding the decimal 4 places to the left. That's a closer look at the metric system and conversions. If you want to see more chemistry matters, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.